feeling ourselves.
Is that to you? Say something.
Talk to someone.
Okay, I found a switch. This is not the one I'm going to use for this, for the actual plane. It's fine for the ignition, but it wouldn't be enough for the plane itself, because it's these only are about 7 amp. 7 amp isn't quite enough. Okay, so I'm going to find my receiver, which should be in the plane. Okay, now I'm going to plug in my rudder. I have to go get my radio. Well, for now I can just set it here. Bottom line is, I'm going to run these little cables down these tubes that they supply for you.
Mark has over 15 years' experience as an insurance adjuster, so he knows firsthand what you need. As an independent agent, he can offer several options for your insurance needs. Auto, commercial, home, and more. Call Mark today at 870-391-3723. You want pictures, but not the same canned poses, right? Let Square Peg Photography is experienced and professional photographers step in to capture your style with a memorable experience. Children, senior portraits, Middle Earth, fantasy, and more, they redefine the norm. Steampunk, motorcycles, to on-site equestrian, and real estate properties. Square Peg Photography does it all. Redefining the norm? Contact Square Peg at 417-243-7734. That's 417-243.
I also noticed there was a few little kinks, and I took the kinks out.
18-76.
Old junker cluttering up your front yard? Turn your trash into cash. Bring it on down to TRG Harrison and Berryville, where you get cash paid for your scrap metal. They pay you cash, and you help the environment by letting them recycle your scrap iron, car bodies, aluminum, tin, and copper. They get you in and out in a jiffy with their express recycling. Doing the dirty work for you. TRG Harrison on Industrial Park Road and TRG Berryville off of Freeman Switch Road. Check them out at trg.net.
One day, a young girl dropped her box of cookies into a bowl of Andy's vanilla frozen custard. You know, those cookies sold by little girls dressed in khaki-colored uniforms. And thus was born the Thin Mint Concrete. It's America's favorite cookie, along with America's favorite custard. Andy's Thin Mint Concrete, now at Andy's.
Khaki-colored uniform not required to eat at Andy's.
This is Andy. Visit us in Branson on West Highway 76, across from the Jim Stafford Theater in front of Track 4.
Okay.
This weather update from Florentina's, celebrating their anniversary. Spend $25 on pasta, steak, lasagna, ravioli, whatever, and you'll get a $15 gift certificate to come back again.
Now, you really got to get these the right length. Sunday. They can be kind of a chore.
For this afternoon, some sunshine, and will turn colder. Temperatures fall back through the 50s. The brisk and cold tonight, clear. Saturday, we get up to 60. Sunday colder with tons of clouds and sunshine. A high just 45. I'm AccuWeather.com meteorologist.
See if they give you any way to.
The Ozarks Best Country, 102.9 The Z.
Temperatures continue to drop. We'll get to the temperature in just a little bit. Let's take a look at the 102.9 The Z color radar. Looks all clear. No precipitation on our radar. And like I said, the temperatures continue to drop. At noon, it was 66. Right now, 58 here at the radio station.
Radar presented by Brighton Ridge in Eureka Springs, Arkansas.
When your loved one needs short-term rehab or long-term care, the caring professionals at Brighton Ridge are there for you and will go an extra mile in working with Medicaid or insurance carriers on your behalf. Brighton Ridge, Eureka Springs, Arkansas.
Guys are gonna really want to go ahead and lay this plane over to be real exact on these. It's you can't, there's not much room for error on these.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna spin my airplane around where I can work on the tail of it here. Working on the pool pull system. Okay, I've got one. I'll put my copper ring down on my wire. Drilled my hole out a little bit. Actually, I need to get a little more. Keep trimming just a little bit with the right size drill bit. Don't go any bigger, there's no need. Actually, gonna have to cut this end off again to get a nice spot there to push through. Usually, a good pair of snippers will leave a nice end on them. Push through and hard. There we go. Okay. Now they're showing these. Third hole down. Okay. Okay, now again, I need to go ahead and put my little pieces of fuel line on here before I get it that far on. Put them on my hemostats and slide them up on there a little past where they go. Now they're showing these in the third hole on your control horns. They do appear to be the right size. I didn't have to drill those out. Okay, pull it tight. Pull it back through here. I'm going to go ahead and take my rudder again because I'm wanting my rudder to be in a neutral position. So I'm going to go ahead and tape it again. A little bit of masking tape. Tape it in the center position. Piece of tape will do that. Okay, I'm gonna pull this up tight. I'm going to go ahead and loop it through, but I'm not going to go ahead and smash these yet. I'm going to... I'm not going to go ahead and smash them yet. It's very hard to get this... this dried, so I'm not going to... I can cut my excess wire out and leave a fairly long piece there. Okay. And keep your wire. You might be able to use it for something in the future. Not long enough to do another pull-pull, but it might be able to use it for something. I keep my remnants, I keep my extra hardware, I keep all that stuff. You'll need it on something. You least expect. Okay, I drilled out my eyelet. Go ahead and I put my copper ring on. Okay. Go ahead and put it through my eyelet. Go ahead and put that on the third hole down. Pull it tight. Don't put a lot of pressure on it because you'll pull your servo off center, which I'll need to check here in a second. Okay. Just be tight. Back through my copper ring. Swedge is what they're calling it. Run it back through my swedge. Push my copper tube all the way up. Okay. Now run it back through. I pull it up, but I don't go ahead and try to get it all the way tight yet. Leave about a 2 or 3 inch piece there and snip it off. Okay. Keep my extra wire. Something in the future I might be able to use it for. Alright. Now I need to go get my radio and make sure that's going to be right before I do that. Now I can actually, I've got these here, which are the springs on your tail wheel. I can probably go ahead and do these. These hook.
Danielle Bradbury, Matt Duncan in your radio. It is a very windy. Oh my goodness, it's windy out there.
Hook right here.
Temperature is starting to fall in the northern reaches of our listening area.
And then they hook on your ends there.
Going on the way, here's Taylor Swift. Mine, 1029 the Z.
We were in college working part-time, waiting tables. Left a small town, never looked back. I was a flight risk with a fear of falling. Wondering why we bother with love if it never lasts.
Actually, I put a little crimp too far up on the wire. So these are the springs for your tail wheel assembly. Okay, and it looks like if you center your tail wheel, that's going to have two little crimps. So you're going to turn that edge down. Turn that edge down. Okay. Okay. Perfect. Now I'm going to go ahead and pull them through. bend them over. There. Bend it over. Not that far off. Okay, now I do it. You bend little U's, you get your distance, and you bend these little U's in it. And see how it wraps around the head of my pliers and makes that little U? That's what's gonna hold it. Gonna hold it on there. Okay, I'm gonna have to tighten this one up a hair. Make my wheel center. Looks like I said I didn't do it just right anyway, so I need to go ahead and make those little U's in it. I'm going to gain a little bit, so I go there, and I go around the head of my little square head pliers, and it gives you that little U. So that will tighten that end up a hair. Okay, and I do the same thing on this one. I want to go past where I was just a little bit. I'm going to go all the way around to make that little U. Okay, now let's see how that works.
Check out our website at 1029thez.com. And thanks for listening to 1029thez.
Yeah, I actually put a little too much pressure on it, but I'm going to go ahead and tighten this other one up a little. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and tighten this one up some. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and bend that back straight, and then I'm going to go just a little further down, and I'm going to make my U head. Here it is. Now I'm going to go ahead and see if that was enough to get my tension that I'm wanting. I really want to get this tension just right. The way that wheel set just right. That way it's kind of hard to get in there. It's actually getting really close. Right on the money. Okay. You know what? I know what to do with those. I'll do that here in a little bit. I believe a little bit of that wire shrink wrap pushed up on those would work. Okay. Now, let me go get my radio. and I'll see how close I am on my pull pull. Try to put some of my tools up as I go. Helps a little. Okay, I'm gonna go get my radio. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Got my radio. Go ahead and plug in my receiver. Like I said, every radio is different, so I just put the radio on and this is the radio that I did the battery mod on a couple weeks ago. And I've actually been using this radio for everything, including I've got it set up to where it'll fly on real flight. I haven't charged it since I did the mod. This is the first battery I put on it. I haven't charged it. I haven't recharged it. From 100%, I'm over 5 hours at least, and I'm only at right now at 37%. So that battery mod was incredible. Please be careful. But anyway, it really increased the life of it. So let's see here. What channel the rudder is. So I go to sub trim. Like I said, all radios are different, so I just look. Rudder is channel 2. Okay.
Want your YouTube videos for your business or professionally produced content suitable for TV broadcast?
I'm gonna go ahead and hook my rudder servo into channel 2. Pull my horn off in here. The first thing I want to do is center my servo out.
Won more awards for their production than any other company in Branson.
Okay.
Let the Vacation Channel produce your next award-winning project. 417-334-1200. That's 417-334-1200.
Would you like to spend less time on the couch and more time in the fresh air? Would you like your kids to stare at a bobber instead of the TV?
Channel 2.
Would you gladly trade in your microwave for a Dutch oven? Then you belong at Bass Pro Shops. Every week we offer free skills workshops to help you get started. See the store or go to BassPro.com for more information. Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here.
You want pictures, but not the same canned poses, right? Let Square Peg Photographers, experienced and professional photographers, step in to capture your style with a memorable experience.
Children, I know why.
Fantasy and more. They redefine the norm.
I'm on the wrong model here.
Equestrian and real estate properties. Square Peg Photographers.
Let me see here.
Redefining the norm.
Model select. 417-243-7734. Revolver 50cc.
7734. Top of Mount Branson, Highway T and 76.
Select.
Hi, this is Amy at Liquidation Network, just off the bypass in Harrison. What will you find to improve your health today? Where everything is up to 50% off of retail. Check our
It has to do with, I set up the elevator as having
protein waters and shakes.
Two channels for the ailerons, two channels for the elevator. So that will actually change the channel assignment for the rudder. So let's see what it changed it to.
Stop paying retail and head to Liquidation Outlet now.
Okay, see, yeah, elevator is channel 1, and elevator 2 is channel 2, rudder is channel 3, okay. And luckily, that's where I plugged it. So,
general dentistry for the people of the U.S.
and the fees
are still among the lowest you'll find anywhere. Routine extractions are still only $39 each with immediate dentures, and you can get a complete set of replacement dentures for as low as $3.95.
Yeah,
dentures and dental services of Harrison, okay. Where you can't afford a great smile.
Thomas John Kennedy,
Arkansas, DDS, PLLC, and Associates.
February is American Heart Month. Heart disease is a major problem and is the leading cause of death for both men and
women. Golly, really incredibly close.
Heart disease is preventable. Every journey begins with a step, and the CDC recommends that your journey to better heart health begins one small step at a time. Don't become overwhelmed. Don't go it alone, and reward yourself.
Go ahead and pull my tape very carefully from my rudder so I don't peel all my covering off.
And 1029 the Z. Proud to support American Heart Month.
Okay.
It's been a cold, hard winter. Work is slow and money is tight. Doc Holliday's and Forsythe is here to help you with some cold, hard cash. That's right. Take a look around your place. How about that mower or boat you ain't using just right yet? Bring anything of value into Doc's, and you will go home with cold, hard cash in hand. Oh, what a warm feeling that would be. We make it easy to make it through the winter. We give you cash for things you aren't even using. That's Doc Holliday's and Forsythe. When everyone else says no, we say, here you go.
These days, many banks say they are ready to make loans. At Table Rock Community Bank, we don't just talk about loaning money, we're doing it. At TRCB, we believe a person's character is just as important as collateral and ability to pay. Hi, I'm Larry Hurst, president of Table Rock Community Bank in Kimmeling City. Whatever type of loan you need, we're ready to help. Log on to trcbank.com or call today. Table Rock Community Bank, your bank, our community. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
With a brought to you from Branson Quick Cash, Tammy here. Did you know Branson Quick Cash could match Friday and payday loans in Northern Arkansas and Southern Missouri? Branson Quick Cash, in business since 1998 in downtown Branson, 417-336-8877.
Very windy for this afternoon, some sunshine, and will turn colder. Temperatures fall back through the 50s. The brisk and cold tonight, clear. 32, mostly sunny, breezy tomorrow, the high 60, then partly sunny Saturday. Up to 60 Sunday, colder with times of clouds and sunshine, a high just 45. I'm AshleyHunter.com meteorologist John Fierick on the Ozarks Best Country, 1029 The Z.
The 1029 The Z radar, currently all clear, 57 degrees.
They're really close.
Radar presented by Harness Boots and Shoes in Harrison.
Do you have feet? Well, of course you do.
I actually think I can go ahead and crimp them. And
your feet love to stay toasty and warm on cold snow days.
Then pull them through and leave them. And then I can do a little bit of adjustment if I need to on my crevices.
Weather twice an hour and the Ozarks' best choice for severe weather coverage. 1029 The Z.
Okay. Remember, I'll still be able to tighten them by tightening up my clevis, so I was just making sure they were close enough that I could tighten them up and have my adjustments. And they appear to be. Maybe about a quarter inch there. Okay. Pull those up real tight.
Good, good, crazy. When she says, baby, everything gonna be
cooked them up nice. Cut them off with just a little bit left on them. Okay. Now, I need to go ahead and adjust these to where they'll be nice and tight. So, I'm going to start with this one. Okay, this one needs to have, first of all, it's just to center it. Looks like it would need to have a little bit more tension on it. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it out. And run it up here. A ways.
From the Clay Maxi Ford Studios, you're tuned in to 1029 The Z.
Like I said earlier, they're putting it into the third hole down on the top of your horn.
Listen to your sweet voice all night long. Sometimes I can get by. Sweet dreams, baby, good night. But this time, well, I don't want to spend it alone. So I'm coming over. Listen to me, pulling into your drive. Look out your window and see my eyes. Baby, baby, girl, I gotta see you tonight. The way the breeze is blowing, blowing. Got me wishing I was holding, holding.
They need to be pretty tight. I'm gonna go ahead and tighten this one up just a hair. Oh, I didn't put one of the little pieces of fuel line on this one for safety. I better do that right now. Now, let's see, we're going to be with it. Oh, here it is. Throw my hemostats, push it down to where it needs to go. It's the right way too. And it's not. So I need to reverse that. So I'm gonna pull it loose. And I'm gonna reverse.
The Ozarks Best Country 1029 The Z. See you tonight from Scotty McCreary. My name is Matt Duncan.
Servo reverse on this radio.
Up by Tim McGraw.
Okay, and I am going to go to rudder.
Lady Annabelle and Keith Urban on the way to
reverse it.
Best Country 1029 to Z. Okay.
See what that does. This one can be tightened up just a hair. Which I did. Okay, those are tight. So let me go ahead and sub trim it a little. It's I'm down to 31%. Love that. Okay. Got rudder. Got elevator. I need to go ahead and put my. Need to go ahead and tighten these little backer nuts up. Yeah. I got it about right. This several times, but I'm going to keep going over it because it's just so important. On any Metal Gear servo, I put Loctite on the screws. It's pretty important because, especially on a gas plane, they'll immediately vibrate out. I know this from experience. To make sure and always put Loctite on your servo screws. You don't have to tighten them up that much, but tighten up some. Little name tag thingies come off on these, and I let me glue them back on. They're an awful good servos, but they did a good job putting a little badge on them. So, take a drop of medium CA. Take a drop of medium CA and put them on with that. It's not open. Gotta find my open one. Careful when you're opening your CA bottles. Sometimes they're hard to get the caps off and stuff, and more than once, if you put a lot of pressure on them, I've shot CA everywhere, and boy, it makes a mess. So I gotta be careful. Really jammed on there.
Clay Maxey with Clay Maxey Ford. Proud of being Harrison, proud to be Ford. ClayMaxeyFord.com.
My fingers together, imagine that. And I got a little cut on my finger earlier. And this is something I do almost regularly when I get a little cut. Go ahead and I glue it. Medium works fine too because it has a little bit of build, but anyway, that little cut that would normally be stinging everything I touched and be all sore immediately goes away. Okay, now I'm going to start. So yeah, it works great on cuts. I'm getting ready to run out of hard drive space here. Pretty close. Anyway, I'm going to put a little Loctite on these little backer nuts and run them up. Again, I used two pliers. It doesn't take much to tighten these up. Just a little bit. They do need to be brought up to it and tightened up a little bit. Do what they're designed to do. Hence the name, backup nut. They actually keep the clevis from just vibrating on those threads and wearing those threads out. They don't fit that tight, and the vibration in time would just wear the threads off the clevises, I guess. Go. All right, now I'm going to do these. I'm going to lay the plane back over on its side for a second. Make sure and heavens underneath it. Yeah, that worked real good. And that's it. For today.